Welcome to episode 18 of Ripping the Rack podcast. My name is Tim, and we have with me on my moderately sized deck in the Big Cat Sanctuary, Brian. How you doing, buddy?
I am doing excellent, Tim. How are you? Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. No, I'm good. I'm good. Would you like to touch my moderately sized deck?
No, but it is comfortable to sit on your moderately sized deck.
Thank you. That's what she said. Mm.
The cats are out here too, Mookie and Luna. They're in their catio.
Yeah,
they're hanging out.
Yeah, we're hanging out. It's a nice day.
It's a beautiful day.
Oh, boy.
Good Sunday afternoon to you, Tim.
Good Sunday afternoon to you as well. Happy Labor Day weekend.
Mm, thank you so much. Happy Labor Day to you, and happy Labor Day to all five of our listeners.
No, I think we're up to like seven now.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah, we're growing exponentially.
Well, the problem is a lot of them are Canadian, so I don't know if they celebrate Labor Day.
Labor?
Yeah, Labor Day.
I assume they do. Well, I shouldn't say assume. I think they do because a lot of people have said they had a three-day weekend up there.
Oh, okay.
So, I'm going to say yes, but I could be wrong. It wouldn't be the first time.
Maybe they call it like Labor Day or something.
I bet
they call it
L-A-B-O-U-R.
Yeah, yep. Okay.
Yep. So, no, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood.
Very nice. Tim, who's our sponsor this week?
Our sponsor this week is none other than Newport Entertainment Center. Guess where they're located?
Newport, Maine?
Newport, Maine. 26 Main Street, Newport, Maine. They also go by NEC.
Mm-hmm.
You'll hear them, NEC. They are a family entertainment center. Fun for all ages. With an arcade, bowling, and pool, there is always something fun to do for everyone.
They have both, you know, candlepin, good bowling, and they have that evil devil 10-pin bowling on the other side.
Yes, they do. Yep. That was a mistake.
Well, no. You know, the house is fast. The pins go.
Well, I'm not going to call it fast, but I'm going to call it fast.
I've seen some 1400s thrown in there.
Yes. Yeah, no, it's, I like bowling there. The only thing I truly don't like about the house, and this is
I bet we share the same issue.
Synthetic approaches.
Oh, God, I hate synthetic approaches.
That is the only thing. And when they built the approaches, they put the ball rack behind the approach.
Oh, God.
Because they went with the old 10-pin style, not thinking that this is candlepin. So,
yeah. So you got to walk 10 paces back to get your bowling ball.
To get your bowling ball. So then they built a little, like, the extension.
Yeah.
But isn't it like carpet or
something?
Yeah, I don't
know. Didn't help.
But no, it's a good house. It's mm-hmm. a fun house.
It's sticky, though.
Well, it wasn't the last time I was there.
I have a hard time on synthetics. I either stick or I just can't stop sliding.
Yeah, no, but you can find them on Facebook, Newport Entertainment Center, phone number of 207-368-2490. Again, that's 207-368-2490.
And a big shout-out to last week's sponsor, Maine Vintage Toys, down in Portland. They gave us a subscribe and a like and posted on their Facebook page about our podcast. So check out Maine Vintage Toys. They're on Facebook as well for all your nostalgic toy and collectible needs.
Okay. This isn't about Maine Vintage Toys, but yes, please check them out because they were nice enough to like and subscribe to us. So, mm-hmm. The reason why we chose Newport as our sponsor for this week is twofold. Number one, bowling season starts this week. For most of us mm-hmm. that aren't scared of, I shouldn't say that. That's,
yeah.
Scared is the wrong word.
Concerned.
Concerned.
And you should be.
Well, yes and no.
If you take the proper precautions, you shouldn't be.
You should be okay.
You should feel okay going out and doing things.
Yeah, and I suspect it's because we live in a state that has pretty good.
Yes.
You know.
We benefit from being tucked away from a lot of people
right.
up here in Mid-Coast Maine.
Right. So, anyway, leagues are starting this week. Looking forward to getting back to bowling.
Tim and I are bowling together on Thursday nights again.
Don't know where yet, unfortunately.
Woo. We could, next week could be very different.
Yep, could be. So, thank you, Newport, for being our unpaid sponsor this week. And so, with leagues starting, and then they are hosting the first official Maine State tournament coming up in 2 weeks.
The 19th and 20th?
20th for the Maine State singles, both handicap and scratch, or as they call it, classic tournament.
We haven't released the betting odds yet, but you know, maybe we'll throw something together after we see who's bowling.
I'm bowling.
So right now, Tim and probably me. So right now, compared to us, I think Tim Girard's on favorite.
I would say so.
I'm the dark horse.
That yes. Yep. So Newport Entertainment Center, Newport, Maine. Mm-hmm. Give them a shout. Check them out. Ooh, I'm a poet. I'm a poet and didn't even know it.
For any other information on the new Maine tournaments, I guess you could talk to Mike Walker or Evan Riva. They're both, I believe, president and vice president, respectively, of the new association.
Yep.
The New World Order, the NWO.
The NWO of Candlepin Bowling. So, yeah. So, looking forward to getting back to, hopefully, some normalcy. Mm-hmm.
Other bowling news, I believe Paul Dyer and his wife bought...
Yes.
All play in Belfast.
Yep. Congratulations, Paul.
Mm-hmm.
Looking forward to it. I have never bowled in Belfast.
I've bowled there three strings. We stopped when they first opened, when it was when Don still owned it.
I no other reason other than I just haven't bowled there.
We'll have to go up and check it out, so support them.
I am looking forward to bowling a tournament there at some point this year. I'm sure. I know they have one. I just don't know what it is. So I am looking forward to...
And then the finals are in Waldoboro.
I'll play in Waldoboro.
Mm-hmm.
Again, synthetic approaches.
Tough house.
Yep. Yeah.
But I guess that's why you put the elimination finals there, right? Because it is tough.
No, the elimination finals, honestly, it shouldn't even be a factor. It should simply be in Augusta because it is...
centralized.
It's the most central house.
And it's got the most room.
It's
really.
Got,
it's the best viewing experience.
Yep.
Yeah, honestly,
it's I don't know why they insist on going to these out of... not that Waldoboro is out of the way, because it really isn't. Well, it isn't for us because it's 25 minutes down
the
road.
I would like to do the finals of the eliminations as a show.
Yeah,
I'm saying that now. Like, okay. If you're not in it, or if, yeah, I'll find somebody, because if you're in it, then I'll have somebody talk with me, and
yeah, and you'll have to that way you can get a recording of me either winning or losing.
It could be the greatest moment, or it could be another crushing defeat.
It could be another crushing defeat.
Speaking of crushing defeats, you defeated your kidney stone, apparently.
Well, I think. I haven't felt it for a couple of days, so I'm assuming that it's passed.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Mm. I hope so.
Sun is bright, by the way.
It is. Any other new bowling news, other than leagues starting back up?
They
already started bowling in Canada, I think, from what I saw.
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
I think I saw Brent Roberts'
post. They're looking for some teams for that league.
Yep. Here's a news flash for those of you that don't know. The Friday Pro League in Massachusetts is not being held this year.
It is canceled.
It is canceled this year. But hold your horses, because, you know, instead of having two teams bowl each other, screw it. Let's have like 14 to 16 teams bowl against each other in the same house. I'm sorry. Can you tell I'm a little bit flummoxed?
I can tell Tim does not think this is a logical decision.
Well, I'm probably going to piss a few people off with this, and shocker, it's Tim. But I don't agree with this decision.
Tim has a polarizing opinion. Who would have thought?
Who would have thought that I had a polarizing opinion? I do not understand. There's nothing you can tell me that's going to make me understand why the Friday Pro League, which is probably one of the best leagues around, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You're bowling one team. So there's two teams in one house.
10 guys.
Call it 10 guys. Call it 15 guys.
Wives, girlfriends, whatever. Other bros, whatever.
Call it 15 to 20 people, okay? And you're going to cancel that league because you think it's too dangerous to bowl. So, how about this? Well, since that league is canceled, let's put a scratch league on Friday nights together at Lita Lanes. Sounds great. Except for, this is not one team versus one team. This is 16 teams, I believe.
Okay, so Lita has 32 lanes.
Yep.
Am I correct?
I think 40.
You could social distance that way. You could do lanes in between each team.
You could.
You
but
have
now,
enough.
But now you have, and it's three teams.
But there's a lot of room in Lita.
It's three people to a team. So now you've got 40 plus people in the building. and don't give me any crap. You are not going to social distance. You're not. It's not going to happen.
I'm just being devil's advocate here and saying it could happen. It could happen.
Yeah, well, I could also grow 6 inches and get a 12-inch penis.
I think both those ships have sailed, my friend. Correct. Unfortunately, I think they are way off on... It's the Love Boat money. It sailed a long time ago.
I have been in the bowling community a long frickin' time. There will be no social distancing going on in this league. Period. End of story. It's not going to happen. We just had the tournament up in Augusta last weekend?
Yes.
God, last weekend. Did we talk about that?
I don't know if we did or not.
Yeah, we did.
I think we did. Yeah, Daly.
Craig and Josh
were in the final.
Oh, wait. Has it been 2 weeks then?
No,
I don't know.
No, it was last weekend. It was.
Either way.
But Mike was doing temperature checks and stuff.
Okay.
I mean...
But there was no social distancing going on.
No, but...
There was a lot of high fives, a lot of hugs, a lot of grab ass, slappy butts, slap hands.
Yeah.
Okay?
I can't say
it. It's bowling.
Okay.
There is absolutely, in my mind, I like Dave Barber. I might be the only one, I don't know. But I do. I like Dave.
Dave's a good guy.
I like John Zappi.
Mm-hmm.
I consider both of them friends, and I have considered them friends for many, many years.
You don't agree with their decision?
I do not agree with this decision. I think it's absolutely, I'm not going to say, you know, I was going to go harsh and go asinine, but it's not. I get it.
Mm-hmm.
There are people out there that are concerned. Cool. I understand.
Yep.
I just think it's absolutely foolish.
And who knows? Maybe.
And maybe it's the fact that I'm up here in Maine.
It could be.
And we have very limited compared to Boston, compared to New York, compared to...
You mean like this guy that's going to Atlantic City in 30 days?
Yeah.
I honestly feel my plan for the golf trip is we go to the house we rented, go to the golf course, come back to the house, and go to sleep.
What about the grocery store?
The way we divvy it up is two people cook breakfast and dinner every day.
Yeah.
So you have your day, and then the other days you get cooked for you. I'm pre-cooking. I'm making lasagna and chili, and just I'll cook breakfast.
Oh, okay.
So I don't have to worry about that. But we'll send one person shopping.
I like breakfast.
You're a big breakfast fan.
I love eggs.
I'm not.
I could eat bacon and eggs. Give me bacon, eggs, and toast.
I can't do it. I'm not a Brenner person. I don't like breakfast for dinner.
God, I knew you were.
I'm not a breakfast fan.
I was gonna say bad things, and I can't because we're now taping, and it's.
I know.
Hot mic. So anyway, getting back to this, I'm sorry, Dave. I'm sorry, John. I disagree with your decision. I know I have no say in it because, well, frankly, I don't bowl in the league.
Mm-hmm.
Then again, I'm 3.5 hours away.
But this is also your opinion.
It's my opinion. Again.
Opinions are like assholes. Everyone has one. They all stink.
Well, I don't know. Some assholes don't stink, I think.
No, I don't know. I never get that close.
I'm just saying.
Oof, nope. Any other bowling-related topics, Tim? Do we have any questions this week?
No questions because our listeners don't like us.
Guys, can you give us something to talk about, please?
RippingTheRackPodcast@gmail.com. RippingTheRackPodcast on Facebook. RippingTheRackPodcast on YouTube. There are three ways to get in touch with us right there.
Please.
Twitter, @RippingTheRackPodcast.
And we're on iHeartRadio now.
Oh, that's right. That's the big news.
News.
Oh, wait. I don't have the...
No, I haven't. I messed. Oh, well.
Damn it.
So news, though. We are on iHeartRadio.
We are now on iHeartRadio. Look us up there. Listen to us there. Listen to us on iTunes. Listen to us on Spotify.
Listen to us every day. Just re-listen to the episode on each different platform every day.
I mean, people will be like, holy shit, look at these guys. They went from 7 listeners to 49 listeners.
Mm-hmm.
It would be great. And then go from 49 to 98.
And then maybe 10,000.
And then from 98 to 196.
And we're syndicated and we're all over the radio.
And then I could quit my job.
But you're the roofing gnome.
I am. I like my job, though.
Mm.
I do. I really like my job.
Hey, another sad news from what I saw.
I'm sorry, but that sun is just fucking brutal on
I
my face.
I saw that on Facebook that Park Lanes isn't opening this year in Canada.
Nah, I saw that. Don't understand their... I didn't...
Oh, like, I guess with the restrictions and everything, they don't feel they could survive working at half capacity, I guess.
Okay. I don't know what the restrictions are in Canada.
I think the business has to operate at half capacity.
Okay.
And, you know, that's a small house to begin with.
Fast
house, though.
Can I... As I'm thinking about it, and you can tell, we don't really have an agenda for this week. Agenda. Hmm. Wow. We don't really have an agenda.
Words are tough, Tim.
Words are really tough. So, getting back to the fact that we don't have an agenda, it just occurred to me. I did have a couple of people reach out and question the fact that I did not have Tommy Olsta on my list.
Ah, yes.
And that you didn't have Tommy Olsta on your list. And I made the comment that Tommy... obviously is my number one bowler of all time that I've ever seen. But we chose from 1990 on, and he got done, I think it was 97 or 98. So he really only had a seven-year stretch out of the 30 years.
Hmm.
Hence the reason why I didn't put him on this list. And then it occurred to me that I actually had a couple of people on this list that actually only bowled 7 or 8 years. And that was... Jeff Atkins and Paul Berger.
That is true.
So,
another funny thing though is they called us out for that. So we turned around and said, well, you guys make some lists and we'll read them on air.
Yep.
They couldn't do it.
No. And I'm not going to call out this one gentleman by the name of Brian Fuller. I won't call him out, Junior. I won't call him out at all. He said he was going to put a list together and I said, great, get it for me. Cause I'll read it on air for you. And he said, absolutely. So, Fuller, I am calling you out right now because I love you, and I'm calling you out because I know you're a big boy and you can take it. But this is what I got from a response to him. My question, did you get your list done? We'll be taping this afternoon at some point. He goes, I didn't. LOL. It's way too complicated. It's so hard once you get past the top five. Uh-oh. Brian's got a look on his face.
Yeah, I just got breaking news from CBS Sports that Djokovic... has been disqualified from the U.S. Open for striking a line judge with a ball. So apparently he did not like that and went off on him and hit him with a ball.
Oh, my God. I can't wait to watch a replay of that.
Sorry. I just saw that pop up, and I'm like, he got disqualified.
Yep. So Fuller said, it's way too complicated. It's so hard once you get past the top five. To which point you said, true story.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, yes, it certainly isn't easy. It's really easy to miss people. And then he said he did start. He started to do one with Walsh from 2010 to now. But even that's a tough one. So.
Lists are tough.
Lists are tough. We miss people.
Oh, yeah. We don't mean to.
I think I actually called myself out for missing Bobby Witt.
Yeah.
Because he definitely should have been on it. So, but I blame him on being too nice.
He throws 130 games and just like, okay, it's what I do.
Yeah, he's too nice.
It's a matter of fact for Bobby to throw 130.
Yep. So, that is, I guess that's my bowling thing. Even though Fuller did put a cool little thing up here the other day. I don't know if you read through a lot of it.
Oh, I saw some. Who has the Grand Slam, I guess, scores?
I don't know if you're calling it that, but he asked, who has hit a 200 for one, a 500 for three, and an 800 for five? And he had put, he goes, he can think of Mike and Chris Sargent, myself, and Jeff Atkins.
Surratt's
never done it.
He's never had an 800?
Never had a 500, I don't believe.
Oh, wow.
I think he has the 800.
That's kind of hard to believe.
And it was just kind of, I was going down through and I was like, you know, I think Al Joy might have done it.
Yeah.
I mean, the guy's got like a dozen 200s and I know he's got an 800, at least one, if not more. I don't know about 500.
Is any woman in that club?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
No, because there's never been a woman that's bowled 500 for three.
Okay.
So... I think the world record's something like 470 for a woman, I think.
I wonder who that is. Honestly, I don't know.
I don't know. I think Baker might have done it. I know Baker also has a 1500.
Yeah.
So if you add a Grand Slam in there.
That's the only other person I know that has a 15 is Robbie Henderson.
Al Johnson.
Al, when he set the record, that's right.
So I don't know if Baker did. I know he's got the 200. He's got several 200 games.
I believe the 790 something he might have done in Newport, because that's why Sarge came up and threw an 800.
Threw an 800.
Yeah, I was next to Sarge for one of his 800s.
I don't know. Peter Flynn, maybe. Surrett's got the 200. He has a 204 and 802, but he doesn't have the 500.
Wow.
And I was an ass to him, and I admit it. I said, where's your 500? One of our, one of mine?
You have three, right?
I have two.
Two.
Yeah.
Does Jason have two or just one? Kaler.
Just one.
The five?
That I know of.
The 512?
Holbrook does not, because he doesn't have the 200.
Boggles my mind. It's the biggest mystery in bowling.
Maybe Robbie Henderson?
I don't maybe. Know. Maybe. There's no single stuff, though. You'd have to take all
his... Well, I know he's got a 200.
Yeah.
I mean...
I think he has a 200, right?
Who, Robbie?
Yeah.
I think so.
If anyone can tell us if Robbie Henderson has a 200, please tell us.
I think so.
Hollett has one, right?
Hollett has a 200.
Yeah.
He might be another one that might have it. But it was just kind of neat looking at some people here, you know, posting their... They're big. I like to see the people's big strings and big series and stuff like that. And
I have nothing close to any of those.
Well,
I'm 188. I'm close to two.
Yeah, you're close.
I'm 188. My three is 463. My five is 665.
Ulster has a. They said he has a 209 and a 504, but he does not have the 800, which surprises
me. Yeah.
Mark Gregory. Does not have the 800. He's got 791. But he's got the 200 and the 500. Matt Cormier has got four 200s. He's got a 500 series and 789. Scott Sorois does not have the... He's got 494 and 776 and two 200s.
Dad is 198. My dad, Ray Athern, 198. 493, and I think 759.
Yeah. Timmy Lipke had, he missed out on the 800, 789.5, but he had the triple at 5, he had 515, and he had four 200s. It's just kind of neat to look back through. So.
How about Charlie?
I don't know if Charlie had the 500. I know he's got the 200.
He's got the 800, right?
I'm going to say yes, but I don't I don't know for sure.
It was tough for those guys back then. The pins didn't go as good. Cuz they were literally wood.
Well, no, I mean
and rubber caps.
In the 80s they were flying.
Did they go to the Garland in the 80s?
Yeah.
The composite pin?
Yeah. Yeah, that was plastic back in late 70s or the 80s, I think.
Are they plastic now or are they composite?
I don't know. It's not wood, that's all I know.
Are they still made in Maine?
Sure.
The Garland factory was down in...
It was down, like, Sanford area, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know. I really don't know. Don't have a good answer for you.
Okay. You seldom do. No, I'm kidding. I give you shit.
Wow. That was rude.
Well, I'm sorry.
I'm letting you sit on my moderately sized deck.
And hang out with your kitties?
And hanging out...
Be surrounded by pussy?
And hanging out with... Being surrounded by pussy. Sitting on my moderately sized deck... What the hell?
Jeez.
You must be a Canadiens fan.
No, God, no. Is this our segment of the week where we talk about that fucking dumpster fire?
Sorry, Angela. Sorry, not sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Bruins suck.
Oh, God, they're awful. They are awful. How about the Knights, though, huh?
How about the Knights?
I like the Knights. They could go to back-to-back cups.
I like them because they're in Vegas.
Yeah, more teams need to be in Vegas.
Have I told you that? Vegas is my happy
place. Weren't you supposed to be in Vegas?
You shut your pie hole.
Wasn't I supposed to go with you?
This would be, Angie and I were talking about that. This would be the week we would normally go. We normally go Labor Day. Oh, God. Excuse me.
Wow, Timmy.
Ooh.
Compliments to the chef.
Compliments to this chef. Okay. Sorry. Sorry. I wonder if we'll have a deer today.
I don't know. Maybe. We had a turkey and a deer last week at Tim's Animal Sanctuary.
And it's birds.
Yeah, birds. We're sitting next to Tim's well-groomed bush.
Those are right. Right next to my moderately sized deck.
There you go. It makes the deck look bigger. Good way to trim it out.
And thanks. Oh, God, I can see where this one's going this week.
Oh, it's going to be terrible. But we're going to get there.
Well, if we're already there, do you want to talk about a song?
Oh, God. Ladies and gentlemen, Tim is now going to explain to me about the song WAP.
WAP by Cardi B.
Because I've never heard it. But from what I've heard, Cardi B is what you get when you microwave Nicki Minaj.
So...
Tim's going to read these lyrics to me now. I've heard what this song's about. I have not heard it, nor have I heard most of the lyrics. So you're going to get my actual reaction.
So I'm not going to read all of the lyrics because, I mean, there's a lot of lyrics on
here.
Well,
she spits straight fire, yo.
Yo. So I'm going to, let me drop down to.
How about you start with the chorus? Tim.
I don't know where the freaking chorus is on this.
Okay, let's just pick a snippet. You pick for me what you think is the most well-written part of this song.
Gobble me, swallow me, drip down inside of me.
Wow.
Quick jump out for you, let it get inside of me. I tell him where to put it, never tell him where I'm about to be. I run down on him for I have a N-word running me. Talk your shit, bite your lip, ask for a car while you ride that dick. Ride that dick. Yes, it says it twice. You really ain't never gotta fuck him for a thing. He already made his mind up before he came. Never get your boots and your coat for this wet ass pussy. He bought a phone just for pictures of this wet ass pussy. Pay my tuition just to kiss me on this wet. This is, oh my God.
Wow. So do you remember Two Live Crew?
Hold on. I'm gonna read a couple.
This is worse than Two Live Crew. This is being celebrated, and kids are listening to this, and I had my Two Live Crew tape taken away from me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you fucking with some wet-ass pussy. Bring a bucket and a mop for this wet... Oh, my sweet baby Lord Jesus. Oh, she needs Jesus.
She needs Jesus. Wow. Can they even play that in Canada?
If he ate my ass, he's a bottom feeder.
Okay, that's funny.
That's actually kind of funny. Oh my!
Well, who listens to this?
Oh God!
How did you hear this song? Is it on the radio?
I honestly don't know how I don't think they play this on the radio.
I don't think they can.
No, it's
if
says,
you edit it, it's just one big loud, like it's three words and just silence.
Tie me up like I'm surprised. Let's role play. I wear a disguise. I want you to park that Big Mac truck right in this little garage. Make it cream. Make me scream out in public. Make a scene. I don't cook. I don't clean. But let me tell you how I got this ring.
Wow. Wow.
Oh my sweet Jesus.
Okay. Oh, I know stuff Colin's never listening to.
Oh my God.
I'm going to let him listen to Two Live Crew rather than that.
Oh my.
Do you remember when everyone had this problem with Me So Horny?
Me So Horny.
And then there's that.
Oh my.
Oh my God. Oh. Someone in Canada tell me, can they legally play that song on the radio in Canada? I don't think they can.
I mean, when your lyrics go, ah, me so horny, ah, me so horny, ah, me so horny, me love you long time, ah, me so horny. And they do this four different times.
I know, but it's not.
Sitting at home with my dick on hard, so I got the black book for a freak to call. Picked up the telephone, then dialed the seven digits, said, yo, this marquee, baby, are you down with it? I arrived at the house, knocked on the door, not having no idea what the night we had in store. I'm like a dog in heat, a freak without warning.
Okay, so you just went through two verses of that song between the first opening chorus and the other chorus. Two.
Yeah.
It sounds like a Bible story compared to WAP.
Oh, my
okay,
God.
Okay, we're done with,
you know,
with
for
that
garbage. For those of you that have virgin ears, my apologies for...
Make sure your kids don't listen to that.
My kids? My kids are all
no,
old.
I mean like people with younger kids.
They're all listening to it.
Man.
Dude, that's going to win a Grammy.
No, please, God, tell me no.
Oh no, that's so going to win a Grammy this year. Meanwhile,
2020, you suck.
Meanwhile, you get songwriters and lyricists like Jason Isbell that get you know.
Speaking of bad shit, the 2020s happened.
Yeah.
Fucking Chadwick Boseman, man.
Oh, man.
Black Panther.
I had no idea that
Wakanda
had...
forever. I know I'm white and I shouldn't say that, but for him, yeah. He was a good dude. He was a great actor.
I had no idea he had colon cancer.
Yeah. They released a picture of him. You know how he hadn't been seen in like months?
Yeah.
He weighed like 92 pounds.
Wow.
He said he went from Black Panther to Crack Panther in one tweet. I mean, he was going to visit kids who had terminal illnesses, and he was terminally ill.
I just can't believe that he did Black Panther and a couple of the Avenger movies with colon cancer.
Yeah, doing chemo. And nobody knew.
Yeah.
Man. And he was Jackie Robinson.
And he was Jackie 42. Robinson.
Like, I saw a great movie last night. Kelly and I had date night. We went to Augusta, and we saw Tenet, the new, the guy that directed Batman Begins,
okay.
And The Dark Knight, and Inception.
We were in Augusta. We were in Augusta yesterday, too. We knew you were there because...
Snap Map
showed me you were at Longhorns when I was talking to you.
I was waiting for Kelly to get an Ulta.
Oh, okay.
I almost asked if you were, but I thought you went down to Nico's and got roast beef.
No, I want... God, I so want...
I heard somebody say Nico's wasn't good.
Oh, you know what? They're full of shit.
No, it was somebody we know in the bowling community. They're like, this is terrible.
I want to know who it is because I want to just...
It was on Facebook. It was.
They're wrong. Nico's, honestly, I love a good...
Was it McGinty? It might have been McGinty.
Well, McGinty. Okay. I love McGinty, but he's an idiot.
Yeah, but he likes food.
Yeah,
man.
He does.
He loves food.
But he's wrong.
I wish I could eat like McGinty and look...
Mario likes...
Nico's?
Nico's.
Mm.
Fuller likes Nico's. Of course, they also live like 5 minutes from
there. I've never had Nico's.
Oh, my God. You got to get their signature sandwich is their roast beef. I personally get the roast beef with cheese.
Mm-hmm.
I do not get the mayo. I get the barbecue
on... it's like Arby's, but better.
I get the barbecue on the side.
Is it like Arby's, but better?
Oh, my God. Don't you dare... You can wash your mouth out with soap.
I didn't know.
How fucking dare you? Arby's? Really?
Hey, you know what? I have unpopular opinions. I don't think there's much of a difference between Chick-fil-A and KFC.
Well, I don't like Chick-fil-A.
Like...
Yes, I said it. I am not a fan of Chick-fil-A. I find them overrated.
It's just chicken.
Overrated. Sorry. Oh, that could be our new thing.
Oh, yeah. We could talk about things that are overrated.
Like Tim's Bowling.
Sometimes. Sometimes.
Wow. You really weren't supposed to agree to that.
Oh, well. So, and then... You know,
that hurt.
Well, no, sometimes the hype machine is there, and sometimes...
The hype machine is...
The angry
hype.
Timmy comes out.
Oh, but angry Tim's fun, Tim.
I remember the Derby one year. Mr. Timmy punched two on a spare in the last box, and we lost. And that's the first time I've seen Tim kick a ball return in front of his mom.
Did I kick a ball return?
You did. We were at South Paris.
Yeah.
We were on.
I kicked a lot of ball returns in South Paris.
We were on 11 and 12.
Yeah.
And you were on the left.
Yeah.
We were bowling Leland.
Yeah.
And you punched a half Worcester two after you made a shot. And we lost by four. And you kicked the ball return, and your mom's like, Timothy! Because she was there watching.
Did I tell her to back off, woman?
No, you didn't. You were very nice.
I was?
You were like, Mom, stop. And you're like, shut up, Mom.
I would never tell my mom to shut up.
No, I think you told her to stop.
I'll probably stop.
Yeah.
Yeah, I might have done that. I kicked a few ball returns at South Paris.
You did.
I kicked a ball return over once at South Paris.
I've never done that.
On 9 and 10.
That sounds pretty hard to do.
During league.
So you broke the lane.
No, it didn't tip over. Like, it didn't, like, flop over, but all the balls fell off.
I once got politely asked to take a week off from the Augusta League on Thursday nights. Apparently, they frown upon it when you kick your ball return. But when you walk to your right across the lane and kick their ball return and get your foot wedged in the hole, they get really angry. That was the year you were supposed to bowl with us, Tim, and you didn't.
Oh, is that the one where I quit?
Yeah, because you couldn't bend over because your back was so messed up.
Yeah, I was a little bit fucked up. I feel like, I don't know, I'm in a mood today. Maybe shouldn't have taped, but that's okay.
I think we're okay.
Hey, say hi to the Snapchat, Brian.
Hey, what's up, Snapchat? Add me, Candlepin Kid, on Snapchat.
Add me, TJM502.
You get pictures of Colin most of the time, and sometimes some other stuff. All good though.
You get pictures of my pussies.
Yep, Tim. Every morning I wake up to Mookie.
You can't tell me though that.
That's how I know Tim's alive every day. Is I get a Snapchat of Mookie.
He's so goddamn cute.
Isn't it his gotcha day? Yesterday. Yesterday was gotcha day for Mook.
4 years.
Wow. Getting old, Mook.
Yeah.
My cat's gotcha day is coming up. She will be 14.
Oh, she's an older cat.
She's an old lady. She's a grumpy old lady.
She is a grumpy old lady.
He gets mad at Colin because he screams at her because the cat runs away and he goes, bad, bad. And he yells because the cat won't come here and let him bet her.
I'm listening, by the way.
Yep.
I'm just sending this snap out because it's important that I do this while we're taping.
That is true. That is true. Yeah. Good job, Tim. We got playoff basketball.
Screw the NBA.
The Celtics are battling the ones from the north.
I'm just kidding. I'm watching.
You know, they're battling the ones from the north, and now it's 2-2, and it should be 3-1, realistically.
Because the Celtics shit their pants?
At least Jaylen Brown owned up to...
And said he sucked?
Yeah, and said it was his fault.
Well, here's a...
How do you get a shot off in 0.5 seconds, by the way? I thought it had to be 0.6.
No. It's actually 0.2 you can get a shot up. 0.2 to 0.3.
I don't think you can.
He absolutely got that shot up in time.
No, he didn't, Tim. We're Celtics fans. Bullshit.
I am a Celtics fan, but he got the shot up in time. It's bullshit that he wasn't covered.
Hey, Jaylen Brown owned that.
See, Jaylen Brown, 2 in a row. Trade him. Here's my take. If you're 0-for-9 from the field,
mm-hmm.
why the fuck are you still shooting the ball?
Because you're trying to heat up.
You try to heat up by driving to the lane, getting other people open.
Tim, you're thinking of 1980s basketball.
Right, you know, when it was good.
No, this is and-one mixtape. You just keep shooting and you don't play defense.
Well, no, they play. That's one thing I'll give the Celtics and I will say Toronto does is they play defense.
Well, Brad Stevens would run the legs off them if they didn't play defense.
I know, they do play defense.
They are the most well-conditioned team in the league.
Oh, I think so. I think so.
Yeah. Brad Stevens is—he's going to be your next Greg Popovich.
Hey, how about the fact that Milwaukee's down
0-3?
I love it.
Oh, I am not a Giannis guy. I used to be, but he's turning into a whiner.
They're all whiners.
Well, some
every
of them
time.
Aren't though.
Oh my God, every single
Tatum's
time.
Tatum's not a whiner.
Oh, dude, have you watched Tatum?
No, not really. Not since college, and I'm a Duke fan. So
I'm a Duke fan too.
There's nothing wrong with Tatum in my eyes.
Tatum.
I think we should go sign Grayson Allen. He's got 5 fouls to give and knows how to give them.
Six,
and he knows how to give them.
Yeah, I'd take Grayson. Dude can shoot.
He can trip too.
Yeah, that's okay. Just don't get caught.
Maybe the Bruins need him.
Oh, fucking Bruins! Oh my God.
Can we please send? Can we take Zdeno Chara to the glue factory, please?
You know what? I love Chara. I have been a huge Chara fan. But
he's
on,
Dustin
dude.
Pedroia level come at this point.
Retire. You know what would be perfect for him? Fine. You
front
wanna
office?
No, you want to be on the team? Great. You're being a healthy scratch every single game, but in practice, you're going to help the young kids.
Yeah.
It's called an assistant coach.
Yep. You can either retire or we'll just help you scratch you every game.
You know, and...
That's the one thing I found in hockey more than any sport is people play way past when they should.
A lot of them do. Yeah.
I'm glad Ray Bourque did, because he got his cup, finally.
He got his cup. I mean, it sucks that he had to go to Colorado to get it.
He brought it back to Boston, though.
I know,
that
was
classy.
Great. That was cool.
Yeah.
It just sucks that he had to go, you know, he had to go elsewhere to get it.
Did you see Tom Brady's brought the Patriot way down to Tampa Bay? People taking pay cuts to sign big-name players?
Oh, my God.
Mike Evans takes a pay cut so they could sign Leonard Fournette?
Oh, it's crazy. It's
Tom Brady's like, you want to win? Watch this. Here's the rules.
You know
you
what
take less money.
You know what I would love to see? It won't happen.
I bet Tom paid him a part of that out of his own pocket. Was like, I need a weapon here.
And it probably won't happen, but I would love to see. Tampa Bay, New England Super Bowl. Just because.
I want to see Tom Brady run all over him.
Oh, he would. There's no doubt. Patriots are not going to be good this year.
Well, everybody sat out so they wouldn't have to have cap space.
No, they're not going to be good. I don't see the
NFL getting past Christmas.
Oh no, they'll be okay.
No, I don't think so.
Dude, this is all over on November 4th.
God, you keep saying that, Tim.
You cannot tell me this isn't political.
Yeah, it is.
Thank you. This is over November 4th. Because if Donald Trump is president.
This is a real virus, though.
Oh, I didn't say it wasn't a real virus. It is absolutely a real virus. I'm saying it's been politicized. It is not
It's as deadly as they say it is.
Okay, so it's as deadly as they say it is, which is you still have a 99.6% chance of survival rate.
You know what my favorite survival rate is?
100?
One fucking 100.
There's nothing that's 100%. Life is not 100%, dude. You're going to die.
At some point. But my whole point, when I wake up every morning, Kelly goes, what are you doing today?
So,
not dying.
Explain to me this, there, Batman.
Okay.
H1N1.
Okay.
Pig flu, swine flu.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
Yep.
There was, how many people died from that? Like a million?
There's a few.
Okay. How come Obama never got criticized for not doing a damn thing?
Oh, I don't know. I hate politics. I'm just,
me too.
I'm a science dude. And all I know is this could kill me. These are the steps they've told me to take so it doesn't kill me. Call me a sheep if you want. They went to school. They've done studies. They've had peer revisions.
That's what we need. We need a sheep soundboard.
They've, you know, we've reached a point in society where it is cool to not like science. Science is knowledge. Fucking things work, okay? Vaccines work.
You're gonna piss off some people.
I don't fucking care at this point. You can't deny science.
Where's my wife?
I'm not sure, but science, again.
Oh, no, dude, you're preaching to the choir. All my kids were vaccinated.
It boggles my... If that's your choice, that's your choice. Don't say it's because an asshole doctor that lied and admitted he lied wrote a paper that was made up. And then you got Jenny McCarthy's kids. She says it happened. She says, Jenny McCarthy says my kids are messed up because of vaccines. Do you ever think your fucking kids are messed up because you're Jenny fucking McCarthy? We're taking medical advice from the bimbo from sold out in the early 90s, or singled out in the early 90s.
Yeah, makes
for
sense.
For fuck's sake, people. Rant over.
I've been waiting for you to go on a rant.
It happened.
It was an okay one.
Yeah.
It was okay.
I'm sorry, folks. I shouldn't bring that here. But.
Why? This is our podcast. We can talk whatever
the hell
we want.
I know, but we're supposed to be talking bowling.
No, we're not. Our podcast is not about bowling.
Well, half of it is.
That's what we thought it was going to be. Our podcast is whatever the hell we want it to be.
Okay, we're changing it up.
Because we're Brian and Tim, and we can talk about whatever the hell we want.
Okay. Hey, I'm on John Steiner's Chatcast again tonight about wrestling. Anybody wants to tune in? Johnny Death Drop on Twitch. We're talking about top 10 all-time catchphrases in pro wrestling. If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
I do. I smell it.
He unfortunately can't smell what The Rock is cooking right now because he has COVID.
Oh, does he?
Yes, The Rock
has
COVID. Has
COVID?
Yep.
I didn't know that.
He says that it was very rough, but he is past the point of being contagious.
Kitty, hold on.
We're going to interview Little Kitty.
We're going to interview Little Kitty.
Let's interview Little Kitty.
Okay. Kitty, what do you want to say? Huh? No. Meow. Yeah? So what do you think, Kitty, about Brian? Oh, I don't think Kitty think twice about it.
No, Kitty just showed you her butthole.
Look at my butthole. I don't know why, but every time, it's one of my favorite memes, it's the cat butthole, and it just says, look at my butthole.
I like the one where the cat's sitting, it's got its leg up by its head, and it says, look at my foot, look at it.
Look at it. Kitty. Yeah? So, ask a question, Brian.
Oh, hey, little kitty, what do you think about bowling?
Kitty.
Ah, very good.
Very good
insight.
Yeah, that's really cool. Oh, that's my phone.
Oh. Timmy, that's very unprofessional. No, don't take a phone call.
It's Jordan.
No.
Hold on. Hey, Jordan. Hey, I'm on the pod. You're being taped right now. What's happening? No, really, you're on the podcast.
Hi, Jordan.
Say hi to Brian.
Hi, Brian.
Oh, it came through.
Oh, it did.
Even better. Oh, let's put you on speaker.
We're going to interview Jordan, folks.
Stop what? What are you doing?
Hey, why'd you call earlier?
Oh, your laundry's ready if you want to come get it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, love you.
Now you're really putting me on blast in front of all your computers.
Yes, because because mommy does your laundry for you and you're 23 years old.
All right, love you, bye.
I love you, too.
You just called out your son on an actual podcast. Hi, Jordan.
Oh, God, I love that kid. It's so funny.
Yeah, but back to what I said earlier about Tenet.
Yeah.
It's a really, really cool movie. It has to do with time travel and it, the whole thing is about objects being inverted. So, like, bullets going backwards into a gun.
Okay.
It's the same guy that directed Memento and Inception.
Yep.
And the Batman movies. Like, it's very thought-provoking. Like, I gotta watch it again to completely understand it.
Okay.
But it's really well acted.
Nice. So you guys had a good date night then?
We did. We went to Sam's. You know, gotta get that toilet paper.
Oh, boy. We went to Sam's.
Yeah, I got adult things like toilet paper and Gain. Gain is my favorite laundry detergent.
Did you get adult diapers?
No, I don't require them yet. Okay. Although, Tim.
What?
Why have you not told me that the majority of the hair on the, like, the end of my, like, by my neck, in my sideburns, in my beard, is white? Why have you not told me I'm going gray?
By the way, Brian, you're going a little bit gray. That's okay.
That is a wake-up call and a half. 35, and I look and I go, oh, God.
That's okay. Dude, I'm 49. I'm going to be 50 next year, by the way.
I know, but you don't have that much gray.
Dude. That's all gray.
I'm 35, man.
Would you like to see my ball hair?
No, I'm good. I bet it's gray and it's distinguished. what do you use, just for men?
No, ball fro. I don't know. I'm just kind of in a...
I'm glistening from my chest pubes down to my ball fro.
It's one of my favorite lines in the movie.
Do you know that movie is 15 years old?
Oh, my God. I remember going to the movies in Brunswick.
I remember you telling me about this. It was when we, like, legitimately, like, first started bowling together and hanging out. I was in the fraternity house, and you were like, you have to go see this movie. And I'm like, okay.
Did you go see it?
Oh, we did.
Did you laugh?
Yeah, the first time I went, I was regular Brian. And I laughed a lot. And then the second time I went, I was super relaxed, Brian. And I laughed even more.
I could understand that. It's still one of the funniest movies.
Oh, God, it's hilarious. That Talladega Nights and Anchorman are like...
Oh, God. Gotcha.
That is the triple threat of...
Of Will Ferrell.
Funny movies that you can just watch and quote. And
yep.
They're Sunday afternoon movies.
Yes. Hmm. Yep. I wake up in the morning, I piss excellence.
Yeah, that's true, Ricky Bobby. If you're not first, you're last.
Yes, that's right.
Why would you listen to me? I was high.
Oh, God. So, we got a little bit of time. We got about 13 minutes left, to be exact. So, what do you want to talk about?
Well, I'm playing PGA Tour 2K21.
Me too.
Are you?
Yeah, I bought it.
How come you haven't added me in friends yet? How come we haven't played online?
Because I don't play online.
But you and I could just play just us.
We can?
Yeah, we can just play around together.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, with headsets. You can get your mic on and we can talk chat while we play golf.
Oh, my God. Okay. I suck at it.
Oh, I'm terrible.
Oh, I'm on easy, by the way.
Oh,
so
me too.
Not...
Me too. So we're perfect.
I shouldn't say I suck at it. I shot like 58.
Yeah, no, I have too. And I love it. I just read the putt. Okay, good. Yeah,
yep.
Oh, fix it if I miss it. Okay.
Yep.
That's what I like about video games, though. I can play easy. I want to shoot 20 under par.
Yep.
I want to try and break every course record. I want to win every event going away.
Have you played any other courses other than the normal courses?
I have not played any of the online courses.
Okay.
Can you play them on easy?
I don't know. I haven't tried.
I don't know. Unlocking. I don't like their club selection. I wish it was bigger. I don't
That's
like
what
it.
She said.
They have none of the TaylorMade irons. They don't have any of the TaylorMade drivers. There's no
M2
or M6.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Right now, I got...
Well, they cost money to do that.
Yeah, but you earn money. Like, I've upgraded...
No, meaning it costs the company money.
I know, but it's just bullshit. Like, half the fucking field plays an M6 now. It's all Callaways and TaylorMades now for clubs.
Why you gotta yell at me?
I'm not yelling. I talk loud. I'm like Samuel Jackson. I'm not yelling. It's just the way I fucking talk.
Luna. Luna! Sorry. There was a pussy behind you.
But no, that's a fun, I've been playing that, and I've been going outside a lot, lots of walks, like
yeah.
I said, getting ready for this golf trip, trying to get my legs under me, so I won't be a dead-ass piece of shit after 18 holes, and maybe I can play 27.
Oh, okay.
We're not playing 36 on this trip. The group I went with last year, we played 36 holes of golf a day for 3 days.
Nope.
Oh my God.
Nope.
I played golf from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. every day.
Nope.
And then we drank until midnight.
Yeah, see, that's not fun to me.
I really liked the guys I went with on the golf trip because it was the same group I had gone with numerous years.
Oh, sure.
It's just I think I'm in a different point in my life now. And I think I'm going with a group that matches that point.
You just want to have fun.
I just want to go down. Yes, I'm going to drink. There will probably be a time where my score is affected by a drink. But,
but you're gonna
I'm on vacation.
But you're going to have fun.
I am, yes.
Yes, and that's the whole point.
I hope I'm going to have fun. I hope it does not become uber competitive because, you know, with the personalities on the trip, it could get uber competitive pretty quickly.
There will be at least one person that will be uber competitive. And you say, have fun. Go be competitive. I'm just going to do me.
Mm-hmm.
And
I played the West Appleton Country Club. And that is a super hole in the wall. It's not even really a golf course.
Right. It's someone's...
It's someone's
farm.
Property.
Yeah.
They have holes there and greens.
Yep.
It's actually not in bad shape. It's super cheap to play.
Yep.
Two of the holes actually meet, and they can land planes in the middle of the fairway.
Nice.
There's three par fives on the course.
Okay.
It's very hilly.
Yeah.
But I just went out and had fun.
Nice.
And played with Heath.
Yep.
My neighbor.
Yep.
And he shot well. He was one over.
Oh, good. Yeah, did you tell him to add that to his handicap for the tournament?
He took the scorecards, so my handicap will be adjusted with my 52 I shot, so I hope it goes up.
Probably.
Yep. Golf's hard. Golf is very hard.
I like golf, though.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't take – the reason why I like it now is I don't take it seriously anymore.
Is that why you like bowling again, too?
Why, because I don't take it seriously?
Because you're not Tim the Dick anymore?
Well, I kind of am with bowling because I still am competitive.
You're still competitive in golf. You're what, a 12 right now, probably?
No,
10 or 12?
I play anywhere between an 8 and a 14, depending on the day.
And depending on who you're playing with and what you can get away with.
Yeah, because I just don't, I don't give a shit anymore. Like, I go to have fun. Mm-hmm. So I don't care about my score. And this year I've only played 3 times.
Yep.
4 times, actually, because we played 9 holes. So 3.5 times.
Which we got to play again because we get a free 9.
That's right. 81, 79, and 78 are my 3 rounds.
Did you hear that, Evan and Maddie and Surratt for the Corbeau tournament? We should let's plug that.
Oh yeah.
Waddles for a Cause Scramble, Monday, September 14th at Nonesuch.
Nonesuch.
It is to benefit the Waddles for a Cause Children's Cancer Fund.
Yep.
Matt Corbeau's son Jackson was diagnosed with leukemia 2 years ago now.
I think it's been 2 years.
Yep. He is doing well, from what I understand.
Yep.
And that's great.
Yep.
We wish Jackson more healthy years to come. But this is to benefit those that are still in the process of fighting and families who have children who unfortunately have these horrible diseases.
Yes.
So get out, play some golf with your buddies and support that.
Yep. So looking forward to it. Should be a good time.
I don't have a team to play with. If anybody wants to play, I do have the availability to play.
Well, find 3 guys and...
I've tried. I've asked 6 people and none of them want to play. None of them can play. The problem is it's the first week back to school up here.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
So, you know, you're trying to get adjusted to whatever craziness that's going to bring.
No, that's going to bring crazy. But again, folks, you just got to get to November 4th. Because this all
ends... Listen to Aristotle, Timmy.
This all ends on November 4th, and let me tell you why it ends on November 4th. Because if the Democrats win on November 4th, then it worked, and they got Donald Trump out. And I'm not telling you if I'm for Trump or against Trump. I'm not telling you if I'm for Biden or if I'm hiding from Biden. I'm not telling you about any of that. My politics will be my politics. I am a registered independent. That is...
As am I.
That is... So I vote independent. I lied. I'm still registered Republican, but I vote independent, which I have for the last 20-plus years. I just have been lazy and haven't registered as an independent. If the Democrats win, then this worked, and now it'll be over, and things will go back to normal. If Trump wins, then it'll be over because this didn't work, so now they need to come up with another way to try to get him out. You're laughing because you know I'm right.
I'm laughing just because...
Because you know I'm right.
Because it's 2020 and...
And fuck 2020.
We shouldn't have to fucking talk about any of this foolish fuckingness.
I know. I'm hungry, by the way. What are you having for dinner?
I don't know. Kelly's bringing me back claws.
Oh, you're having claws.
I am having claws. My father-in-law is having Chinese because he doesn't want claws.
So, for those of you that don't live in this area, which is the majority of you that listen to this, there is a wonderful place in down. Well, it's not even downtown anymore. It's as you're coming
in the north end.
In the north end of Rockland.
Not Boston's north end. Not nowhere near that nice.
It's called Claws, and it is a seafood
takeout stand.
Takeout stand. You can eat there.
Yeah, there's a nice deck overlooking the ocean.
They have a larger deck.
They do.
Yes,
big deck.
Size deck.
Many can sit on their big deck.
But it is fantastic food. I mean, it's their haddock sandwich is probably the best in the area.
Their haddock basket, one of their pieces of haddock, is the size of Fiestaware.
It's
plate.
It's very
huge.
Large.
You get great portions. It's
a
well
little,
priced.
It's moderately. I would call it moderately expensive,
mm-hmm.
meaning it's not.
But for the atmosphere and the quality of the food,
it's not outrageous. It is on the water. You get a nice view of the harbor. Oh, hey there, Mr. Is that a chickadee?
That is a chickadee.
Yep.
Maine State bird.
Maine State bird. Chickadee-dee-dee. Sorry. So, when Brian says that his father-in-law is getting Chinese versus Claws, I, okay.
Yeah. Jack's also a guy that orders a ribeye well done.
I will never understand getting steak well done.
Won't eat a filet because they won't cook it.
Well, no. You're not. Oh, I like Jack. I do. I like Jack.
Jack is your... He's originally from Lubeck, which is basically the furthest point east in America you can go before the ocean.
That is true.
And, you know, there's some down east sayings, you know, downstairs, and this foolishness. And he's in his early 60s, and he knows what he likes.
And that's what he, yeah, yep. Okay.
It is what it is to Jack.
Yes. Yes.
If you don't like it, you don't have to go with him.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I turn 50 next year, and I say that twice because we're going to go on a trip.
Yes, we are.
And it's going to include...
I've already told Kelly.
And it's going to include a couple of rounds of golf somewhere.
Yes.
I'm leaning towards Vegas. Part of that is because I love Vegas.
I've never been.
But the other part is because it has Wolf Creek, which is about an hour and a half north of Vegas in Mesquite.
So we'll leave the girls to do the pool.
Girls can do whatever they want to do. I want to play golf for my 50th.
Man, if we're going to Nevada, you best bring SPF 350.
Dude, I've been 6 times.
I know, but you don't tan. Although this year you have tanned a little.
It's my job. It's because I wear shorts and a short sleeve shirt every day.
Man, you used to just turn red, white, red, white. You look like a candy cane.
I did. Now I just stay white to moderately white.
Mm. Like vanilla ice?
Yes.
Moderately.
Moderately M&M?
Moderately white.
Yeah. So we're gonna wrap up here. We got about 2.5 minutes left.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That's, I don't know that.
I don't
just
know.
Continue.
Okay,
go.
Continue.
Cool. Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine. It's hilarious.
So I have been watching Cobra Kai.
I've not yet.
I started watching
is
that on Netflix. I like it.
Sweep the leg.
I like it. Because it brings back the memories from the early 80s with Cobra Kai. And
when you were in
Johnny
your prime
and,
teenage years.
No, my prime teenage years were 85 to 89.
So I was 0 to 4.
Yeah, you were 0 to 4. You know, yeah.
What year did you graduate high school?
89.
I started kindergarten in 90.
God damn. You suck. I'm getting old.
It only took me 14 years to graduate. No, I'm kidding.
I'm getting seasoned. That's what I am. I'm seasoned. So next week, I don't know what we're going to talk about. Guys, tell us what you want us to talk about. Give us something to
post
talk
some,
about.
Post some league scores. We could talk about those leagues starting.
Yep.
We'll talk about our leagues, who's bowling in them, where we're bowling. We're still kind of almost up in the air about where we're bowling.
Kind of, I don't know.
More to come on that next week.
Yep, more to show up on that.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got like 45 seconds left, so I'm going to end with my little... little tidbit of don't be stupid. Wrap it before you tap it. What other idiosyncrasies? Not idiosyncrasies. Idioms. I don't know. I guess wrap it before you tap it would be the one I'm going to go with this week.
If you're not going to wrap it, stay home and whack it.
You, okay. All right.
If you're going to honer, cover your boner. I got a lot of them.
Oh, my God.
I was a teenager in the early 90s. There's a whole lot of Adam Sandler's I can talk about.
Oh, sweet Jesus. Thank you for listening. I appreciate it. We appreciate
it.
Be kind. Be safe. Do good things. Don't be dumb.
Do
don't
good
be an
things.
Ass. Brian, what do you want to finish with?
I love all you. Thanks for listening.
I can't end on an I love you.
Oh. Thanks, everyone.
All right, guys. Thank you. We'll be back.